tell her she's beautiful, the finest girl in all the land. And when you love her, you tell her she's beautiful again.
What's happened today in the Folktown Market is our final traditional skills workshops. So we have food demonstrations, traditional baking, butter making, that kind of stuff, kind of talking about how we used resources in the Victorian times, because they were really good at that and maybe not so good at that today. So something we can learn from that. And then we have a fantastic Steffi who's doing her rope making demonstration, and then traditional children's games workshops. And then we have weaving and harvest knots right in the season for that as well. Some lovely ladies who usually work in Colchoa, so they come in and show us that. And it all links in with kind of our broader heritage celebrations that are running for a year. So we're kind of bringing alive the skills, the trades that were in this area, which was very alive indeed some 200 years ago even. And all linking to our new artwork as well that we launched last week, where we have some references to all these trades. And you can actually see the people that lived here and the type of trades that were here. And also in the artwork is a wee reference to the traditional street games that, you know, kids would have played in Belfast. So we're bringing that all that alive today.
So I have four on here and a nice hot griddle. And it'll take about roughly between 8 to 10 minutes on each side, and then we'll flip it over. So very quickly you'll see it starting to double in size. And what's happening is the baking soda and the buttermilk are coming together in the heat, and it's giving off the gas.
I'm making hemp ropes, skipping ropes mainly for children, but halter ropes and all sort of ropes, because Belfast used to be famous for its rope works, the Belfast Rope Works Company, world largest rope and twine industry in the whole world, and nothing is left. That's what I'm doing. So there was 3,500 people employed, and I'm left.
There's a good history, these different streets, like Bank Street, Berry Street, the first favourite hospital in Ireland was buried there. You've got St Mary's, the first Catholic chapel, you know, paid for mostly by Protestants. Market Street, the first prison. Castle Street, the other part used to be known as Mill Street, and actually as on the way through here, in 1641 there was a wall around Belfast which came down this way here. Plus the River Fartet is flowing underneath the bank buildings and such. So you know, there's quite a lot of history that probably people don't appreciate. That's the idea, just really to highlight that. The way it used to be.